super male. I'm no Superman.
Hi, and welcome to our first broadcast of On the Wire, WFDUTV's latest show. My name is Molly Holt.
Hello, everybody. My name is Erlyn Pena. Thank you so much for tuning in this evening.
We have a great show planned for you tonight.
We have everything for you, from sports to fashion and more.
But first, we have footage from one of the craziest nights of the year. Elise went out to our election watch night party to get the opinions of real FDU students on the election. Let's take a look.
Hello, guys. My name is Elise Wesley, and I'm here with WFDUTV. And we're here at the Student Union Building in FDU Metropolitan Campus. And today is November 8th, a very important election day for the United States. And we're going to get a few people, faculty, and students' opinions on today's election. Jessica O'Brien, and reporting live with WFDUTV. And I'm here in the Student Union Building at the election watch party. So what gave you guys this idea to hold this election party?
Well, I was lucky to inherit this event. I believe that it's before my time. They had the election night watch party. We host this event to not only provide access to the election, but we do all types of activities before tonight, registering students to vote, watching the debates, providing information for students about the candidates.
Do you think that there's a bit of a tension in the room, or do you think that everybody's just like, you know, sitting at the edge of their seats?
I don't think there is a tension, which is a beautiful thing to witness. This has been a tense election, and it's been, I think, really draining emotionally, spiritually, mentally on all of us. And that really speaks to the student population, how they've handled themselves, respecting each other's opinions, coming out, having a great time, great energy tonight.
I'm here at Aaron Hall. And Aaron, did you vote today?
Absolutely. I had no choice.
Okay, that's good to know. How was it at the polls? Was there a lot of tension? Was there a lot of people?
Honestly, I'm from Mount Vernon, which is in New York, and you know, it's a blue state, so I wouldn't say it was a lot of tension per se, like in my neighborhood as well, but the lines were long. The polls for the lines were very long.
Do you think that as a college student it was very hard for you to get back home to vote? Do you think that maybe the campus should have done something like more to help people vote on campus?
Well, honestly, like growing up, you know, they opened all the public schools there's no universities in Mount Vernon, but they opened like the high schools, elementary schools, and middle schools for everyone and anyone that can vote to vote. So I feel like FDU should definitely have, you know, a designated voting area.
I'm here again, Elise Wesley with Emmanuel Attalo, and I'm going to ask him a few questions about this event here. So is this the first time that you went to election watch party at FDU?
Yes, it is my first time, and it's a good environment. You know, the aesthetics is nice, got a nice decorations, good music, it's fun.
Okay, did you were able to vote today?
Yes, I was able to vote, and it was my first time voting, and it's kind of excited, but unfortunately, I felt like it's like voting with the two letters of the age pool, so like, I don't know, I wasn't really too excited about that being my first time to vote, like, kind of voting for someone just because, you know?
Yes, understandable. So, are you nervous about the results that we might find out today?
I'm very nervous. I'm very, very nervous, but hopefully America does the right thing.
We're still here at the Student Union Building at FDU campus while students patiently and anxiously await America's fate, along with the rest of the country. Only time will tell America's path for the next 4 years. Once again, I'm Elise Wesley, reporting live with WFDU-TV, and back to you guys at the station.
The election night party ended before the results were announced. Early the next day, Donald Trump was elected for president.
Obviously, there were some mixed feelings about the results, but that's behind us now. Up next, we're going to hear from Mike and Vanessa as they catch up with the FDU track team to capture a day in the life of an FDU night.
Hi, I'm Mike Natoli, reporting outside the Rothman Center at the Metro campus of FDU for WFDU-TV. Reporting for Vanessa Gonzalez, and me and her are going to check out the season that the track team here at FDU is having this year.
And we're here with
Taurus Agree.
Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Are you nervous about like the meets that you got coming up?
Sometimes I feel nervous. It all depends on the type of meet that we go to. I don't normally get nervous, but for a big event like the national championship, then I'll be a little bit nervous.
Yeah, so before a race, I like to be by myself, just take some time to really get in the zone, and I like to listen to music as well. That really gets me, you know, in the right headspace.
What's your name?
Mae Thompson.
And how's your season going?
It's going okay, thank you. We actually just finished the cross-country season, so now we're preparing to come indoors. The indoor season starts in December, so I'm excited to see. I had a pretty good cross-country season, so I'm excited to see how it translates on the indoor track.
Well, my expectation for this season is to break the 1,000-meter records for the school that has been set for, I think, before I was born, so that's a lot of years ago. So I want to break that record. I want to go below my PR, which is a 2:10 in the 800-meter.
So we're in the Northeast Conference, which has, I think, 9 schools in it. So we came in with a third-place finish last year, outdoor conference. So for indoors, I think we're really trying to work on that. So we'll be looking to compete with LIU, Sacred Heart, sort of those types of schools.
So I just want to meet all the teams to be able to represent the school at the highest level.
That's awesome. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you so much for being with us.
Mike Natoli and Vanessa Gonzalez reporting for WFDUTV.
Thank you, Mike and Vanessa. That was great, wasn't it, Molly?
It was. It was really good to see how our hardworking athletes spend their time here. Up next, we have a fun segment for you. It's called Hot Topics, and it's hosted by our own Ashley with special guest Janai.
I'm so sick and tired of Professor Fox and all of this video production homework that he gives us. I need a break.
I'm tired of this project. Oh my god, my hands are just, they're just so sticky now.
It looks nice.
I hope it does. We need a distraction. I need to get off this.
Let's talk. Girl talk.
Oh, you know I love talking. What's new?
So, let's see. What's new? You know, Younger May and her
yeah.
She's gone a little crazy lately.
How crazy?
So, apparently, she had a concert, and there were some fans who didn't have their phones out to record her, and she was not feeling it at all. So what happened was, she decided to yell at a fan and, like, curse out the fan, like, where's your phone? If you don't have your phone, you need to move to the back of the concert, and someone with a phone needs to move up.
Are you serious?
So serious.
Oh, no.
So then, after cursing her out, like, she kicked the fan out and then brought up a fan with a phone.
Out of her concert?
Out of her concert. That's not even it, though. She had another concert on another date, and she's 8 hours late.
8 hours?
8 hours. And
when
she showed up. Hey, thank you. She's still living in Brooklyn.
That's what I'm saying.
So she showed up 8 hours late, and then she wasn't happy with the amount of people that showed up for the concert, so she decided not to do the concert. And she pocketed $33,000 from that concert.
She's bougie. That's a bougie girl.
Bougie?
Oh, she's bougie. Oh. Did you hear what happened to Kanye West?
I've been hearing a little bit. But give me the details.
So he had a show in Sacramento, right? And he's on tour and stuff, right? So he's in the middle of his concert, he just stops rapping and he just starts talking to the crowd. They're like, all right, cool, Kanye, yes, talk to us. He starts rambling about Jay-Z, Beyonce, how he would have voted for Donald Trump if he would have voted. Like, don't do that. And then in the middle of it, he just says, you know what, guys? He just ends the show, drops the mic, and runs off stage.
Get out of here.
Now, the next day or two, I think I heard he's in the hospital. So we're in the hospital, and everybody's saying, like, he's suffering from depression and paranoia. I'm like, this Kanye.
So what happened to the rest of his tour?
I heard he canceled the whole thing. It's no more.
You're serious?
Yes.
Oh, my
All
God.
All his fans.
Did you hear about his interview with Ellen?
No, what happened?
Oh, my God. Hold on, let me get it for you. Take a look.
Are you connecting? Picasso is dead. Steve Jobs is dead. Walt Disney is dead. Name somebody living. I have ideas that can make the human race existence within our 100 years better. Period. The paparazzi, whatever perception you have of me, starting with the truth, starting with what everyone's thinking. Start there, put some dope with it.
So I was also hearing about the T.I. and Floyd Mayweather drama again.
Oh, here we go.
Again.
Oh my gosh.
You know they had beef like in 2014.
Yeah.
And the whole reason behind that is because apparently he had sex with Tiny, T.I.'s wife. Right.
Mm-mm.
So get this. At Mariah Carey's Halloween party last month.
Yeah.
They took a picture and Tiny posted it onto social media. So, of course, the media had a frenzy and all T.I.'s fans were like, you know, this isn't good, whatever. So she comes out and she's like, Mariah is the one who came up with the idea for me to take the picture with him and to post it on social media. Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
A few days around Thanksgiving time, social media outlets came out with a video.
Oh, the video!
Dancing at the party. I'm sure Mariah didn't come up with that one.
I don't see. Hold on.
I got the clip of that one too.
Oh yeah, please, girl. Let me see.
Where else am I going to brush my teeth?
Anyway, let me tell you what happened this summer. That the school's keeping it a secret, huh? So, this summer, I think the maintenance guys, they're all going around each window, just checking up everything, making sure all the pipes are working, and they found that there's lead in the water.
Lead?
Lead.
Lead? Like L-E-A-D?
Yes, the one that's it's not good for you. So, they never told any students anything. I think the dean and stuff, they never told the students. So now, we're over here bathing. Water, brushing your teeth,
get
and
out of here.
So, like, people need to know about this. I don't think this is safe. I don't know.
Who did you hear that from?
I have my sources, but let's just say it was an RA.
An RA? That's how you know it's legit.
That's what I'm saying. FD's keeping secrets out here.
But they always do. What else is new?
This is unsafe.
Hold on. Oh my god.
What happened?
Thinking of RA. Remember this kid?
Yeah.
He was arrested yesterday.
For what?
Child endangerment. And he's a substitute teacher.
The dude who beat the planes?
Yes.
Oh my god.
He apparently, they had a month-long investigation going on him. They got a warrant for his house, and they found out that he's been, like, using the internet to access and watch and share.
While he walk around this campus?
Child pornography.
Hot topic. Oh my god, that's some hot topic.
Right?
Are you serious?
I can't. No. It was hot in here.
Like, the other day, he said hi to me in the cab. I was like, hey, he's so nice, and now he's
we
oh my god.
Thought he was nice. Nice.
After you got secrets.
I'm going to go back to my studies now.
This is too much. I need to get back to this. This guy.
Right.
No more hot topics.
Hi guys, my name is Elise, and this is Fall Into Fashion. Today I'm here with my special guest, Kelly McCray, and we're going to be talking about the most popular trends this fall and winter season. First, we have Kalia in her green dress, and this green dress is a green midi dress. So the green midi dress that Kalia has is something that can be worn to work or out to cocktails. So first we have the dress shown with the thigh-high boots and a cardigan, and then we also have the dress shown without the cardigan to spice it up a little bit. Next we have Kalia's two-piece sweater outfit. It is gray and may be a little plain for some people, but that's why we spice it up with the neon green shoes. And it also has ruffles on the shirt to make it a little more, you know, nice. What do you think, Kalia?
Well, I can definitely say two pieces are in this fall. Even the simplest sweater pieces, they still make a big bang.
All right, and finally, if Kalia can stand for me, we are showcasing the infamous thigh-high boots that everybody loves this fall and winter season. It can be paired with also another trend, sweater vests. It has the fur on the inside, a good suede on the outside, suede tan to match the boots, and it could be paired with simple skinny jeans and a simple bodysuit to bring the new outfit out. Thank you, guys. I hope you learned some new fashion trends this winter and fall season. Next, we're going to be showing a segment called Wine and Dine with Caroline.
For tuning in to another episode of Wine and Dine with Caroline. Welcome to those who are tuning in for the first time. I'm your host, Caroline, and today's show is going to be filled with lots of sweet treats, holiday cheer, and a good host. Before we get into the goodies, let me introduce my lovely co-host for today. She is a songwriter, singer, and she does a little bit of cooking on the side. Let me introduce Arielle Waters.
Hi, Caroline.
Hello, hey, everybody. So, since it is the holiday season and the time of year that we love to eat, well, at least I know I do, I prepared some quick little cute treats for us.
Okay, they look really good.
Thank you.
Here today.
Thank you. So, before we even get into the treats, tell me a little bit about some of your favorite treats when you were younger.
My favorite treats. For the holiday season, I mean, you can't go wrong with milk and cookies. You know, we got to sneak some of those in before Santa gets to them. But my aunt and uncle used to make eggnog every Christmas.
Well, I never had it.
Oh, my God, it's so good. But I was a little girl, and they had it with liquor, and they used to put it in the fridge. And when they used to fall asleep at night and I was sleeping over, I would wake up, sneak into the kitchen, and grab myself a glass.
You got lucky. You was a lucky child.
Exactly.
You was a lucky child. I know when I was growing up, I used to steal the candy canes off the Christmas tree. Like, it got so bad, my mom would, like, stop putting candy canes on the tree. And I would be, like, so hurt. But all this talking has me wanting some wine. You want some wine?
Please, and thank you.
I think we need some wine.
However you get this open. What kind of wine do we have here today?
We got some peach. You know, peach is my favorite flavor. Nice. Can't go wrong with peach.
Never.
Yeah. And a little proud.
Technical difficulties. Would you like me to give it a try?
Yeah, you can go ahead.
Okay. See if these claws help me.
See, it's the nails. It's the nails. She got the nails on. All right. So,
y'all see, she got a little cherry in the glass. You're getting fancy today, y'all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Just gonna take a little bit. Can't have too much. All right. So, we got our wine and we have our treats. So, we're gonna get right to it. So, what I have for us to make today, I put together some cute, simple treats. I'm not a big cooker, so. You know, put together whatever I can find. So, what we have is marshmallow snowmen.
Those are cute.
Thank you. We have our reindeer nutter butters. Whoever loves peanut butter. I don't. And then we have our Christmas treats pretzel sticks. So.
Are those peppermint on the front?
Those are peppermint. You know, I had to throw in a little Christmas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The candy canes. That
candy canes, yep. Mm-hmm. All right, so, you ready?
I'm ready, let's go.
So, I think we're gonna start off with the snowman first.
Okay.
So we're gonna take a straw, and we're gonna take some marshmallows. So, you're gonna need three marshmallows.
Do we need all these marshmallows?
We don't, but you know, we could eat the rest right then. So you're going to take your three marshmallows.
All right.
Good? Okay. You're going to take one. Mm-hmm. Take the other.
I feel like somehow I'm going to...
It's going to get a little sticky here, so. And then you're going to take your last one. Stick it right through there. And we got a little nice naked snowman. So we're going to dress him up.
So first I took pretzel sticks for the hand. So you're going to take one pretzel stick. And what I did was I broke it in half. Didn't really need a whole pretzel stick.
That's nice.
I stuck one a little sticky. Took one arm.
One arm is shorter than the other, but okay.
That's fine. Mine is too. And then take the other arm.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you got you ahead of the
I'm
game.
I'm way ahead of you.
You ahead of the game. All right, take the other one. All right, you got a little snowman with arm.
Little short arm.
All right. So then for the eyes, I kept it real simple, and I used, you know, little chocolate chips. Chocolate chips? All right, and I just stuck them on there. They should stick. I'm going to stick them on there. Got one. You got it?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, okay. You stuck it the other way, but okay, that'll work too. That'll work.
What does it make sure it stays?
Take another one, and we got two eyes. You got two eyes?
I believe I do. I hope it don't fall out.
All right. So we have two eyes. You have them. Okay. You got one eye popping out. You got the other one in, but that'll work. All right. So every snowman. Oh, my eyes are falling off too. Okay. So every snowman needs to be dressed because it's cold outside. He needs a scarf, his hat, and everything else. So what I used was fruit roll-ups.
Oh.
I love me some fruit roll-ups. So
I don't think I've had that since the first day.
So let me put my little snowman down for a minute. So I took fruit roll-ups and what I did was, I just ripped a part of the fruit roll-up off. Any flavor will help. I folded the fruit roll-up.
I should probably take my piece too, right?
Yep. Go ahead. And I wrapped the fruit roll-up around. Things falling.
He wanna see.
Okay. This is all part of the show. This is all. Look, you still got
time. My eyes are still. They're hanging on strong. I think my scarf might be too short.
That's all right. As long as he got a scarf on, he'll be fine. Oh, I lost another eye.
All right.
So my snowman has one eye. He's gonna be all right.
Oh, my eye's gone. Alrighty.
We gonna make it work.
We gonna make it work. Just get him an eye patch or something.
That's all right. All right. One eye Willie over here. We gonna make it work. You got. Hers is cute. Hers is cute. All right. So, I'm going to use a pretzel for his hat.
For a hat?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's cool.
It's going to be a nice creative hat. All right.
Oh, my eye.
So, as you've seen, we made some snowmen. Not all together, but hers is cute. Hers is real cute. Where's the other
missing
eye?
An eye.
It's missing an eye. But when we come back from break, we are going to make some easier treats. We're going to focus on these reindeer Nutter Butters. And we'll see you guys after the break. That was so different.
Oh, my God.
None of this would be possible without my production crew, my audio crew, my directors, my producers. So why not welcome them all up to the stage right now? Come on, guys. Come on up. Get some treats. Let's party. Wasn't that great? That was great. Thank you to all of you. And now we're going to get into Ariel Waters' performance.
Santa baby, just slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, a 54 convertible to light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Think of all the fun I've missed. Think of all the fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year I could be just as good if you check off my Christmas list. Santa honey, I want a yacht, and really that's not a lie. Been an angel all year, Santa honey, so hurry down the chimney tonight.
Come on guys, let's have some fun. Come on, come on.